one of the most famous quotes of the revered Nelson Mandela is about education. According to the iconic freedom fighter, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. I'm Shane Seeley with the penultimate Central Bank of Barbados program in a series promoting greater discussion on growing the Barbadian economy, the value of the foreign exchange sectors. Our focus in this program is on developing a working class which can sustain national growth in a world of ever-changing technologies and thinking. In this regard, the major educational and training institutes around the island have all moved to steer a youthful population away from the standard public service related and private sector sedentary employment to more innovative and entrepreneurial activity. The national goal and initiative is being spearheaded by the 50-year-old Barbados-based CAFIL campus of the University of the West Indies.
We are going to put a cap on the social sciences and drive the students into technology and science, because we believe that this now, in the digital age, is the future. And the Caribbean now needs desperately to go through a science and technology revolution. The whole Caribbean now desperately needs to go through a transformation of science and technology.
The drive to earn or save foreign exchange is also backed by the Samuel Jackman Prescott Polytechnic. According to the SJPP principal Hector Bell, plans are well in place to shift focus to innovative courses such as underwater welding and textile design.
The Skills to the Future program, which is being financed by the Inter-American Development Bank, that in itself will act as another major fillip to assist us in training Barbadians to take advantage of the renewable energy sector, and at the same very time, it's foreign exchange.
The importance of developing life skills which may be peddled anywhere in the world to this country's financial benefit has not been lost on the Technical Vocational Education and Training Council. Henderson Eastman, the TVET's executive director, says they've been hard at work creating standards in new areas such as health, wellness, and renewable energy, including energy audits.
We are also looking at wind turbine maintenance, installation and maintenance, because people are using a combination of wind power as well as photovoltaic, wherever possible, to meet their energy needs. I think as the industry, the car industry, transport industry goes hybrid or fully electric now, we will have to look at new standards now for hybrid cars and electric cars and things like that.
Dr. Gladstone Best says, as far as he's concerned, his institution is providing the engine of growth for new industries such as culture arts.
Our associate degree in music and our associate degree in theater and dance and graphic design and visual arts, those programs have developed a number of persons who now contribute to the cultural industries. So when we combine then what we do in the areas of allied health, the cultural industries, the visual and performing arts, and the hospitality, that provides a very strong basis for the development of the human capital in Barbados.
And for the SJPP, its major thrust from now on will be training for hands-on employment in a global market.
We can only provide X number of jobs to the growing population. Therefore, we have to look outside of Barbados in terms of job opportunities for our students. And for the Caribbean, and I think unemployment is a problem in the Caribbean. So we just cannot look at the Caribbean. We have to look outside of the Caribbean. So in providing training, we must think, should I say, globally rather than just regionally, because that's the only way that the training could be effective and efficient to our graduates.
Clearly, there's tremendous success ahead for Barbados, given the magnitude of the effort being made to reposition itself as a country which can continue to punch above its weight in the world. One such benefactor from the policy to shift towards self-employment is a trained economist who gave up his job to become an entrepreneur. Jeremy Stephen is also the current president of the Barbados Economic Society.
Now, if we are expected to grow in this economy, we have to, as a small open economy, utilize the IT skills that are available to us. And I guess you might ask where you can get them, where you can get these skills from. And these are available online. Anybody can really go online right now and learn anything. I taught myself computer programming. Some people might say I might have a gift, but there are millions of people that have taught themselves programming. Education has been reformed online to the point where you get university courses for free online from MIT has university courses. You wouldn't be awarded a degree, but they have open courseware. Stanford has their own courses online. Harvard has courses online. Then you have stuff like Khan Academy.
And so, with the challenge of the South African icon ringing in our ears, Barbados can look to the future, knowing that once again, education can create the leaders of tomorrow from the youth of today. I'm Shane Seely with another in our current series, Growing the Barbadian Economy, the value of the foreign exchange earning sectors. Now join us next week for the final program. Please also visit our website at www.centralbank.org.bb or follow us on Facebook for further information.